We are at Sutton Hoo, one of the most important archaeological sites in England. It's on the southeast coast of England, near the River Deben. In 2009, a farmer found a treasure hoard of Anglo-Saxon artifacts in central England that may tell us even more about the Anglo-Saxon culture than what was found here at Sutton Hoo. But for now, the Sutton Hoo excavation is the primary source of information about the culture we see portrayed in Beowulf. People had known for a long time that the burial mounds, the barrows that you can see, were here. In fact, several of them had been looted at various times since the 7th century. In 1939, the first excavations were made, and archaeologists were astonished to find in what's known as Mound 1 an intact ship burial very much like the one described in the prologue of Beowulf. In this excerpt from the prologue to Beowulf, notice the use of alliteration as well as the description of the ship burial. Forth he fared at the fated moment, sturdy shield to the shelter of God. Then they bore him over to ocean's billow, loving clansmen, as late he charged them while wielded words the winsome shield, the leader beloved who long had ruled. In the roadstead rocked a ring-dight vessel, ice-flecked, outbound, Aethlin's barge. There laid they down their darling lord on the breast of the boat, the breaker of rings by the mast, the mighty one. Many a treasure fetched from far was freighted with him. No ship have I known so nobly dight, with weapons of war and weeds of battle, with breastplate and blade. On his bosom lay a heaped hoard that hence should go far o'er the flood with him, floating away. Although in Beowulf the ship floated away out to sea, scholars believe that this particular ship burial, the one that was buried behind me, was dragged up from the Deben River, which is just over this hill, and buried intact here in the mound behind me. This seems to be a burial ground that was reserved for people of importance, people who were great leaders in the Anglo-Saxon culture. No one knows for sure who was buried in this ship burial, but the best guess is that it was Redwald, a Saxon king of East Anglia, who was mentioned by the Venerable Bede.